Welcome back to r/legaladvice, where we read surprisingly interesting stories that usually don't end in a cliffhanger. If you are new to my channel, please feel free to subscribe to join our awesome community. And without any further ado, let's dive right in. And the first one is titled, Neighbor has threatened suing me and other new homeowners because we have devalued the neighborhood by buying homes at their current market value. Background info, I will try and make this as concise as possible. I am in Northern Virginia and my wife and I bought our first home in December 2014. According to our real estate agent, homes in Northern Virginia were worth a lot more in the spring of 2014 than they were in the fall/winter of 2014 and 15. According to him, there was a mini housing bubble for a couple of months last year that crashed and the Nova real estate market corrected itself. Today, homes are simply sitting longer and buyers are getting better deals than ever before. The townhouse we bought was originally sold 10 years ago, new construction, for $389,000. This June it was listed at $415,000, set on the market until late October when it went under contract for $385,000. The buyers lost their funding and the home appraised at less than the agreed upon purchase price. The home fell out of contract the first week of November and we made an offer of $370,000 that same day. We went to settlement on December 5th. The townhouse we bought is the largest of four model types, just shy of 3,000 square feet, an end unit, and is one of a small handful of end units that happen to have over 5,000 square feet of land. In total, there are, I think, 85 townhomes in this portion of our master planned community. All of the homes in the community that are for sale are still sitting at the pre-bubble price/square feet of around $155 per square feet. We paid around $130 per square feet. And now onto the meat of the story. It snowed here a few weeks ago and I had the opportunity to introduce myself to a few neighbors as we collectively complained about clearing snow from our driveways and sidewalks. I attempted small talk with douchebag, I will explain more about him in a minute, and he was generally unfriendly, but I chalked it up to being pissy about the snow. Why is he a douchebag, you ask? He drives a Range Rover, bumps very loud music through it at all hours of the night, typically comes home at 10 p.m. to 11 p.m, drives very aggressively in the neighborhood, etc. It is one of those, you know it when you see it kind of things. Just take my word for it, he is a douche. So yesterday I am getting a few things from my truck and see him and just make a friendly wave, say hello, make some small comment about the nice weather and smile. He looks at me and becomes visibly pissed off. Hands clenched, defensive position, head turned cheery red. At this point I simply ask him, big mistake, if I have done something to upset him. Oh boy, he loses it. Long story short, he is overwhelmingly angry that I, among a few other new homeowners, have devalued the neighborhood because we bought homes that he thinks are now below market value and this is going to start a trend of a total devaluation of the neighborhood. In total, since mid-November, four homes have sold in and around the $360,000 to $370,000 range. All of them, including mine, went on the market in mid to late summer and were priced at spring level prices initially. Douchebag calls out the addresses of the other three homes and yells at me how much he thinks they should have sold for. He then goes on to discussing that the house that he bought a few years ago is now underwater in value as
"This seems to be the new trend around here."
At this point I am done with being yelled at in the middle of the street, tell him to calm down and that I am heading inside. He then makes a series of comments where he more or less said that he had an attorney in the family who he was going to get to help from and file suit against the four new homeowners as we have devalued his property now. He is in the smallest model middle unit with the smallest yard. My question and concern is, I know someone can bring suit for anything, my concern is that he's actually going to follow through with this. I and my 6-month pregnant wife are worried sick that he's going to cost us a lot of precious time and money. A quick Google search does not reveal much of anything if there is any established precedence or successful case of existing neighbors suing new homeowners because they got a deal on a home. In the event I get served, what kind of attorney should I look for? Would this be something that my homeowner's insurance would help me with? Lastly, we have a pretty restrictive and responsive HOA. Should I let them know about this possible issue? And someone in the comments said, he will get laughed out of court. You are under no obligation to overpay for your home to suit his sense of what the market value of his own house is. And now we will read the update to the story from before. The plot thickens with an out of control idiot teenage son and the HOA being pretty pissed off. I know this is long, but trust me, it is well worth the read. Where to start? The other weekend Nova got snow. Where I live, we got a lot of snow, over 10 inches. I only have a lowly shovel, a neighbor I have never met owns a brand new huge and powerful snow blower, and being the nice guy he is, he helped quite a few of us out in moving the mountains of snow that fell. I thanked him and told him I owe him a six pack of something delicious. After some polite,
"Nah man, you don't have to do that,"
comments, he told me that if I were to pick something up and he were not home, one could place a six pack in the ledge decorative crate that is on his front porch between the rocking chairs, and he would not object to finding a delicious treasure in there. He is a nice guy. That following Monday, 3 days later, I went to the grocery store and among my items was my nice neighbor's six pack. I did as he said, put the beer in the crate on his porch, noticed his security camera, and waved to his security camera. On Wednesday evening, I saw douchebag McG as I was pulling into my driveway. Hindsight, I'm fairly certain he was likely waiting for me to get home. As soon as I get out of my truck, he starts shouting from across the street that I will be going to jail for providing alcohol to minors. He goes on to say that he discovered his kid wandering the neighborhood wasted on late Monday night. I immediately put two and two together and realized that his son stole the beer from my nice neighbor's front porch crate and drank it. I ignore him and walk right over to my nice neighbor's house and jokingly ask if he got my beers I left him. He says he did not, and I tell him he may want to review the security camera footage for the last few days. He laughs and tells me that he already did that and directs me to his garage where he shows me his kid's damaged snow toys, sleds, discs, tubes, and from what him and I can piece together, I place the beer in his crate in the evening. Douchebag teenage son came onto his porch minutes after, stole the beer, kicked and left a dent and crack in the siding of the house, grabbed a sled and took off. We head into my nice neighbor's house to watch slash review the security camera footage and he shows me what he just described. Fast forward a few hours later, an obviously intoxicated teenager comes back with a broken sled and takes a disc and tube from the side of the house and pees on the AC unit before leaving. About 20 minutes later, he is back with his empty bottles, smashes a few of them in the gutter, and puts the broken snow toys back on the side of the house. All this happened when the nice neighbor and family was not home. At this point, I tell nice neighbor about douchebag's legal threats and he decides that we should speak about him at that next night's Wednesday HOA meeting. I head home, ignoring douchebag's continuous yells from across the street. Wednesday night comes and nice neighbor and I get up and address our problems with Mr. Douchebag to the HOA. Nice neighbor starts by talking about the theft as well as the damage to his kid's toys and siding. I get up and discuss the legal threats made. At the same time, the other three neighbors get up and crumble. That douchebag had threatened them with a suit as well. One woman, a tiny wave of a woman mind you, said that he cornered her against her car when she got home a few weeks ago. She went on to say that he seemed pretty drunk too. At this point, the HOA president, the attorney for the HOA, and the property management representative call for calm in the room. Other neighbors were getting mad and ask those of us who have been threatened by him to stick around, including nice neighbor. According to my wife, while I was traveling for work this Monday, cops showed up at nice neighbor's house in the late afternoon, took a statement and a flash drive of the video. Nice neighbor came over to my house and told my wife that the HOA told him to go ahead and call the cops to report property destruction and trespassing. The cops assured him that they are not interested in speaking with me, that they are going
after this little shit
because he's a problem at his high school, and that they are not unfamiliar as to who he is. Again, according to my wife, the cops then head over to Douchebag's house, and after some yelling, Douchebag Jr. comes outside and they arrest him. My wife said they pulled out of his pockets what looked like a small bag of weed and a glass pipe. I got home late last night and received an email this morning from the HOA president addressed to me, nice neighbor, and the other three new homeowners. In it, it stated that they were made aware by the cops that they had arrested the teenager and that the HOA attorney was looking into figuring out a way to stop the legal threats from Douchebag. We were assured that there's no legal precedence for suing someone because they purchased something for less than you did, but nonetheless, they are here to help if need be. So that is where we sit. Unfortunately, no more further updates other than that. Either way, I hope you're satisfied with that. In addition, if you have watched until here, please feel free to post some star emojis in the comments and also like the video if you want to support me. All help is very much needed and appreciated. Thank you so much. And the next one is titled, I was wrongly accused of DUI and the police left my car on the side of the road and it was stolen. I was stopped by a patrol officer on a motorcycle because there was a complaint about a drunk driver in the area with a car like mine. I passed the field sobriety test and then the officer said I would be taken to do a breathalyzer. A patrol car came so I could be taken to the station. I was told my car would be towed to the impound lot and asked to leave my keys in the ignition. I was released when the breathalyzer showed a zero. The officer at the desk at the station said my car would be brought from the impound lot, but that never happened. Later, another officer said a tow truck was not actually called and my car was never actually towed, and so he would drive me back to where I was stopped, but my car was not there. He double-checked that it was not towed. The police believe it was stolen because it was left on the side of the road when the officer at the scene was called away. Another officer back at the station took a report about my car being stolen. I called my insurance company and also faxed them a copy of the report. They said it's up to the police to pay because it was their fault. The police say they did not do anything wrong and it being stolen was an accident. I have talked with three people at the police station and two people at my insurance company, and each side says the other has to pay. Meanwhile, I am out a car only 4 years old that I had owned for less than a year. My insurance company won't even pay for a rental. I work for myself and cannot afford to pay for a rental myself. Sometimes I have to drive further than the buses here go. I just started my own business and I am barely breaking even and I need my car or I will lose money. Who is actually responsible for paying me for the stolen car? Edit, this is not about me being wrongly accused of DUI. I lost someone to a drunk driver and have no problems with the police following up on potential drunk drivers. The police also followed the law in terms of me being taken to the station and released me as soon as I blew a zero. The officer who handled this part was polite and professional. My complaint has nothing to do with the DUI accusation. It is solely about my stolen car and no one taking responsibility. And guys, I'm curious, how big of a problem is drunk driving where you are from? Let us know in the comments. And a user in the comments said, the coverage you purchased from your insurance company determines whether you will be covered in the event of theft. Most comprehensive coverage policies will cover you if your car is stolen. If you have proper coverage and the insurance is refusing to pay after any applicable waiting/recovery period, then you will either need to file a complaint with your local department of insurance or retain an attorney to sue your insurance company. In an ideal world, the insurance company should pay out and then seek compensation from the police department, all without you having to do anything. If you plan to sue the police department, you will still need an attorney. Their actions do appear negligent, leaving a newer model vehicle unattended with the keys in the ignition. And now the update to the DUI story. My car was definitely stolen as it was not in any tow yard anywhere close to here, and both the police and the towing company have no record of a tow truck ever being called to the scene. I filed a complaint with the police department after trying to take it up the chain of command and no one helped me. In response, I received a letter saying I need to talk to my insurance company and that although it is regrettable what happened, the police consider the matter closed and any more complaints by me about this will open me up to legal action against me and make me liable for costs paid to the police department. I have spoken with over a dozen people at my insurance company and all of them tell me the same thing: to take it up with the police. They also won't let me cancel my insurance on the car and are threatening to send me collections if I don't keep paying them. Without a car, I am losing so much money because I cannot run my business properly. I have rented a car on a few occasions, more money I've had to pay, or spent hours on public transit a few times trying to get where I need to go. I have also lost business because I could not get to my customers. I have a lawyer now because the police and the insurance company won't even talk to me now, so that is another expense for me. I am hoping my lawyer gets results because if this keeps up, I won't be able to afford my health insurance and rent anymore. I cannot say more now that I have a lawyer, but I did want to post an update and thank everyone for all the helpful advice. I will post another update when or if this gets resolved. And actually guys, I did some investigative digging and it seems that from what I understood, OP actually got the money back from his insurance, but of course he did not get his old original car back. And you know guys, one thing that I did not really understand about the story, at the end he said that the police considered the matter closed and that any more complaints by him would open him up to legal action and make him liable for the costs paid to the police department. How is it even possible that the police can say something like this to a citizen? Especially if they were obviously involved in the matter and if they did a mistake. Therefore, I'm curious, did you ever have any negative run-ins with the police? Or any situations that resemble this one? Let us know in the comments. And the last one is titled, "Found torn up remnants of a Plan B box in the kitchen garbage. My wife, 27 female, should have no reason to use emergency contraceptive because I had a vasectomy years ago. Hey everyone, I don't know what to do in this situation because I never expected I would face something like this. I'm trying to stay calm and rational and examine every possibility, but I'm coming up seriously short here. I met my wife on Tinder at the end of 2015. We talked on and off for some time before she agreed to meet me. By the end of our first date, we found that we had so much in common that we even agreed we should have met a lot earlier. We were both into the same sport, we were both into the same books, and we both saw eye to eye on social and political matters. More than anything, we were both against the idea of having kids. I know, heavy topics for a first date, we were on a roll and just kept talking, and before we knew it, we were 3 to 4 dates ahead of the curve. At the very least, I held off on telling her about my vasectomy until the third. Her immediate reaction upon hearing about it was of an instant of shock, where she could not believe a young guy would get one. She immediately followed that by commending me for my conviction about being child-free. We dated and had a great time with few real arguments and eventually settled down with a big wedding and a big house. After getting married, if anything, our relationship has only gotten better. 4 nights ago was the first time I ever had any serious doubts about our relationship. My wife was out with a friend and I was doing some house cleaning. I was throwing away a bunch of semi-large garbage that can fit into bags and so I took a few things out of the kitchen garbage bag to make everything fit into 2. At the bottom I saw a light purple box where half of a lowercase n and an uppercase b were visible. I immediately recognized it for what it was and reassembling the torn pieces just confirmed it. I had known that my wife was on her period because when I tried to initiate sex, she told me so. I found it odd because her previous period had ended just a couple of weeks before and I made comments about the timing being odd. She told me it is just lady stuff and it happens sometimes. I figured it made enough sense and let the issue rest. I have not told her that I found the box. When she got home that night, everything was so normal. I tried to gauge how she was feeling or if she seemed like she was trying to hide anything, but could not find a single thing. The more time this simmers inside of me, the more the possibilities start springing to my mind. What if she was assaulted? What if she was covering for someone else by bringing the box home and disposing of it here? What if she, for some reason, just felt pregnant randomly? Or what if she just cheated? I only know one thing for certain. Unless someone broke into our house to dispose of a box of Plan B and cover it with a bunch of other trash haphazardly, she was the only person other than me who could have thrown it away. I don't even know how to ask her or how to bring it up. We have both expressed adamantly that cheating is ridiculous because if you are dissatisfied enough in a relationship to be unfaithful, you should just leave. I have done nothing to displease her, at least that I know of. Maybe I'm just naive, or maybe the situation is more complicated than I am giving it credit for. However, I feel like a coward for being unable to bring it up 4 days later just because I don't know how. And a user in the comments said, Plan A, confront her non-aggressively, Plan B, currently in the trash, Plan C, ignore the issue. And guys, I'm curious, what would you have done if you were in OP situation? Furthermore, for the ladies in the comments, did anyone ever cheat on you? And if yes, how did you find out? Let us know in the comments, if you want. And now the update to the Plan B story. I would like to preface this post with an apology. I know it has been nearly 3 weeks since I last posted. To be honest, in no world did I ever imagine people would continue to show so much interest in my situation. I've been online long enough to know that a few weeks here is like an eternity in the real world. Not to make excuses, but since my life just fell into the gutter, rolled into a drainage grate, took a trip through the sewer system and then got eaten by that random ass giant spider from the original It, I have legitimately not had the time or the heart to update you. For that, I am sorry. For the people who are legitimately concerned about me, thank you. It is encouraging to know that thousands of people are thinking about me. For the people who wanted to see my situation go about as bad as possible and play out like a Greek tragedy, I apologize that it is probably not nearly as interesting as you are hoping for. Now to start where things left off. After making my original post, I combed through all of the comments to find reasons as to why she might have torn up a Plan B box and thrown it into the garbage. A lot of them made sense. My greatest hope was that it might have just been old. Maybe it was before we even met. Clinging to that, I handwrote a flowchart of all of the routes our conversation might take. I am awful with confrontation and considered every possibility before bringing it up, what I would say in response and what I would do. I memorized them all. On the evening after I made my original post, I called her into the living room when she got home from the gym. As I had practiced, I asked her the following question. Hey, I'm not accusing you of anything, but could you tell me why there was a torn up Plan B box in the garbage? The second the words Plan B left my mouth, she immediately looked like she had been punched in the stomach. She was completely lost for words. I already knew at that point, I retained eye contact and repeated my question. Why was there a torn up Plan B box in the garbage? You know I had a vasectomy. She just mouth breathed, looked at me horrified. Then she looked to the floor, then she started weakly sobbing. This was not on the flowchart, I had no idea how to respond. I thought if I let her cry it out a bit, she might give me a real answer, but she just kept sobbing. Finally, I prompted her with another question. Are you crying because you did something you regret? She shook her head violently. I was so concerned because I thought something horrendous might have happened. She abruptly shrieked,
I'm crying because my effing husband does not even trust me.
I have literally never even seen a person that angry, let alone my wife. So I prompted her again. Just tell me why it was there. You don't have to hide anything from me. She yelled at me again, repeatedly,
if you don't trust me, this marriage is hopeless. F you for not trusting me.
This line of questioning repeated itself until she told me to get out of the house. I refused and said that until she was upfront with me about why the box was there, I was not budging an inch. She then informed me that either I had to leave or she would leave. Since I doubted she had anywhere to stay, her parents don't live anywhere near us, I agreed to go to let us cool down and have a rational conversation like adults later. I went to my best friend's house, the guy who was best man at my wedding, and we got drunk and talked about everything but her. The following night, I texted her asking if she was ready to talk. She was not. Instead, she gave me an ultimatum. I had to first apologize, second, promise to never bring it up again, and third, learn to trust her completely. Only then would she allow me back home. If I could not do all three of the above, she was done with me. I have not returned home, and we have now been no contact for over 2 weeks. I am wearing out my welcome at my best friend's house, who has been nothing short of amazing. I currently have a consultation with a lawyer arranged this afternoon. The lawyer will probably tell me I'm an idiot for leaving the house, and she will probably be right, but the idea of ever stepping foot in that house again makes me sick to my stomach. There is legitimately nothing my wife could say to salvage this marriage. I am entirely numb to her, what she's doing, who she's with, or anything else even tangentially related to her. None of my family members know what happened, and as far as they are concerned, we are still the happy newlyweds. I'm holding off on saying anything until I am calm and rational and won't do something I will regret in the future. Too long didn't read. Yes, she cheated. Yes, the marriage is over. And yes, I feel awful about it. Guys, please let me know in the comments what you think about this story. But honestly, I think that OP sort of dodged a bullet there. I mean, sort of, because he already married that woman. But I think it's better to find something out like this early than it is to find it out 30 years later. And with that, we have reached the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed today's content, and if you did, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel to join our amazing community. Furthermore, don't forget to go to r/ripestories on Reddit to post your own stories if you want me to read them out in a video. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I see you again tomorrow.